Hello and welcome back to TUNANOCRUST. There are many ways to become an icon, but one of the most effective is to be mysterious. If anyone can be behind the mask, it tickles our brains like few other things can. And in the world of car shows, nobody's better at creating an air of mystery than Top Gear's character, the Stig.
Some say that he appears on high-value stamps in Sweden, and that he can catch fish with his tongue. Some say he's wanted by the CIA, and that he sleeps upside down like a bat.
Part actor, part driver, all incognito. Welcome back to TUNANOCRUST, and we're here to tell you how the creators of Top Gear kept the Stig's legend alive, and what happened when one of them removed his helmet. You won't believe the crazy ways the Stig was able to hide his identity for over a decade. We've already done a video or two on Top Gear, Britain's biggest car show. But just in case you're on the wrong side of the pond, here's a quick summary to bring you up to speed. The original Top Gear, which aired from 1977 to 2001, was a televised version of a vehicle review magazine that exposed people to a lot of cool cars but didn't appeal to a more general audience. What started as a vehicle review show accelerated into a show of extremes when Top Gear was rebooted in 2002. When they reviewed a car, they put it through its paces on the track, in mud, and sometimes even crashed it. The new exciting formats breathed new life into this staple of British television. And when they wanted to push a car to its limits, Top Gear brought in the Stig.
Did it fill with smoke? Did it lose power? It would help, of course, if we could talk to the driver and find out what actually happened out there, but it's just stopped working, like a TV on standby.
The mute test driver's identity has been the show's longest-running joke. He would also help out on the star in a reasonably priced car segment, but for the most part, he was about driving cool cars as quickly as possible. You need to know a bit about the world of professional race car driving to really get the Stig's mystique. Let's start with, don't try this at home. It's a lot harder to drive a car at hundreds of miles per hour than it sounds, and it is dangerous work. The people who get paid to race professionally can drive vehicles at over 100 miles per hour. That said, the Stig was always played by a professional driver. The Stig's anonymity also plays with race car drivers usually wearing full face helmets. Neat. But the Stig has a history beyond that. The name Stig comes from a nickname new boys got at the school Willman and Clarkson went to as boys. Even though it was relatively innocent to haze the new kids by calling them Stig, that came from a children's book, Stig in the Dump, carrying a connotation of poverty. Can't imagine that now, can you? The Stig was always introduced with one or two humorous quips, such as being terrified of scouts or never blinking.
Some say he never blinks, and that he roams around the woods at night foraging for wolves.
But all we know is, he's the Stig. The Stig could tame any car and drive on any track. Like James Bond and Batman, he was meant to drive awesome cars that most of us could only dream of touching. The Stig himself described his character as a mystery driver, someone who would remain anonymous and remove the human element from high-speed testing. Someone who was superhuman. If racing had a superhero, it would be the Stig. Before we go on, note that there have been three official Stigs. The Black Stig, the first White Stig, and the second White Stig. The Stig also has an extended family, including a dad and several cousins from various parts of the world. Every iteration of Top Gear, including the American spinoff, has its own Stig. We'll be talking mostly about the first White Stig in this video. But it's pretty impressive to see how far the idea has come. So without further ado, it's time to take off the mask. Who was the man behind White Stig number one? The main driver who played the first White Stig was Ben Collins. He began looking for work on TV after seeing declining attendance in the stands. He called the BBC after learning that they were looking for drivers. He thought he botched his interview. Interestingly, he talks about how shy he is in recent interviews on VINwiki.
Which for some reason, I mean, I never really wanted to be on television. I was quite a shy person. So this was horrific, even though it was in the middle of nowhere, but there was somebody about half a kilometer away that could have seen that I was making an ass of myself.
The anonymity of the Stig was probably very appealing. It's worth noting that even during his time as the Stig, Collins drove other cool cars for other movies. He drove cars in several James Bond movies, including Quantum of Solace, Casino Royale, Skyfall, and No Time to Die. He also did stunt driving for The Dark Knight Rises and National Treasure, among others. It's quite an IMDb page if you want to see it for yourself. But celebrities usually aren't allowed to have much of a private life. How did he pull it off? Collins went to great lengths to conceal his identity, even from other cast members. Whenever he went to the track, he wore a balaclava to hide his face. He would also approach in a hood and a t-shirt or wear other outfits that concealed his face. He also took things further with a fake ID. To keep his anonymity, he created the pseudonym Richard Jameson. Everybody on staff was in on the joke and let Richard Jameson do as he pleased. But Collins' shyness may have helped keep the Stig's true identity hidden, as per the VINwiki interview. The easiest way to maintain the secrecy is just don't tell anybody, don't ever get seen. Only the showrunners, Clarkson and Willman, knew the White Stig's true identity. Even Collins' family didn't realize he was the White Stig. This got riskier as the years went on, with concerned people wondering where Collins went at times. At least he had fun with it. The powers at the BBC also contributed to the Stig's mystique. For starters, there was always more than one Stig. Several people played the White Stig during Collins' run. Any identity reveals only applied some of the time. Some celebrities were also revealed as the Stig. Even though everybody watching knew that these stars couldn't be the Stig, they kept the mystery alive by muddying the Stig's identity even more. There was no way Barack Obama could drive a race car that well, right? One of the more notable reveals, and a very deliberate red herring, was Formula One racer Michael Schumacher. Top Gear announced that the Stig's identity would be revealed in the Series 13 premiere in 2009, a day before the episode aired. Schumacher was shown beneath the helmet, implying that he had been the Stig the whole time. Of course, given how poorly he drove, the show's hosts dismissed the idea immediately. But this didn't sit well with the public or with Collins. The Stig's secret identity was about to come under a two-pronged attack. The Stig's identity had been the most searched topic on the internet in 2008. Of course, the rumor mill was churning. At this point, Collins' name was one among many. Credible rumors that Collins was the Stig had started in January 2009, 6 months before the episode with Schumacher aired. Some of it couldn't be helped. A News of the World article had somehow found that the White Stig was a married man in a 300,000-pound house with a salary of £150,000 from his various racing roles. But Collins himself contributed to the rumor mill by offering signed prints to the owner of an art gallery and not concealing his Stig gear when someone came over for home improvements. Had Collins not chosen to reveal his identity at all, the press would have had less to work with. At the same time, it doesn't seem like he had anything to do with the initial article. There is also the possibility that several newspapers knew Collins was the first White Stig, but didn't tell anybody out of respect. Shortly after the rumors, Collins decided to let the cat out of the bag. In August 2010, the BBC and publisher HarperCollins got into a legal battle over Collins' autobiography, The Man in the White Suit. One of Top Gear's producers, Andy Willman, had this to say. The whole point of the Stig is the mystique. The bizarre characteristics he has, the wonderment created about what he might think, feel, or do, or look like. HarperCollins have decided none of that is as important as their profits. The lawsuit ended with Ben Collins being allowed to publish his book. The Man in the White Suit was published on September 16, 2010, and Collins retired as the White Stig. But legends never die, and the Stig was no exception. In a special episode parodying the birth of Jesus, Top Gear revealed a baby White Stig. The hosts assured viewers that Stigs grow up fast, so he would be driving in no time. The current White Stig remains anonymous, but who knows? With social media being everywhere and the press hungry for the next big thing, the secret might be out sooner than what happened with Collins. According to an old Reddit thread, there are several second White Stigs. Don't try to do that math. Meanwhile, Ben Collins continues to influence racing. He went behind the wheel as recently as 2022. His company, Ben Collins Autosport, offers insurance for other racers. In other words, he's doing fine. Follow him on YouTube at Ben Collins Drives if you want to see more from the man behind the helmet. But could you keep a secret as big as the Stig? Honestly, Collins kept it up for a long time, but he couldn't hold it forever. What's the longest time you've kept a secret, and what would you do to protect it? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell so that you don't miss the next big thing. We'll see you next time.